वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अनदर एसे रिटन बाय जोसेफ एडिसन, सर रॉजर एट होम। सो दिस एसे वॉज ऑल्सो पब्लिश्ड इन द स्पेक्टेटर, अ पीरियोडिकल विच वॉज स्टार्टेड बाय जोसेफ एडिसन। सो इन द इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट ऑफ द एसे द स्पेक्टेटर्स अकाउंट ऑफ हिमसेल्फ, आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू अबाउट द स्पेक्टेटर क्लब एंड इट्स मेम्बर्स। So in the previous essay we have read that Mr. Spectator makes a plan to give an account of himself to his reader. He also decides to give information about other members of the Spectator Club. So here in this essay Mr. Spectator is going to give a description of Sir Roger de Coverley, and Sir Roger was also a member of the Spectator Club. Mr. Spectator describes Sir Roger as a cheerful, gay and a hearty person. Sir Roger is a gentleman who is in his 56th year, and Mr. Spectator also gives account of his surroundings of his home and his domestic helps. Okay, so now let's start the explanation of the essay, Sir Roger at Home. Having often received an invitation from my friend Sir Roger de Coverley to pass away a month with him in the country, I last week accompanied him thither and am settled with him for some time at his country house, where I intend to form several of my ensuing speculations. So, Mr. Spectator tells the reader that he often receives invitation from his friend Sir Roger de Coverley to spend a month with him in the country. Country means rural area or village area that is far away from the cities or towns. Okay, so Roger has invited Mr. Spectator so many times to come and stay with him in the country where he lives. Okay, I last week accompanied him thither and am settled with him for some time at his country house. So, last week Mr. Spectator went with him thither. Thither means to that place. Okay. He went with him to stay at his place at the country, and he decided to stay there for some time in his country house, where I intend to form several of my ensuing speculations, where he planned to write many more of his upcoming papers. Ensuing speculations means his essays or his thoughts. Okay, so after so many invitations, Mr. Spectator decides to go and stay at the country house of Mr. Roger de Coverley. He also plans to write his upcoming papers there. Okay, Sir Roger, who is very well acquainted with my humor, lets me rise and go to bed when I please. Next, Mr. Spectator says that Sir Roger knows my nature or behavior very well. Humor means behavior or his nature very well, and that is why he lets me rise and go to bed whenever I want. That means Sir Roger allows him to wake up and sleep according to his own will or preferences. Okay, dine at his own table or in my chamber as I think fit. Sir Roger also allows him to dine at his own table or in his chamber. Dine means having dinner. Okay, so he allows him to dine at his own table or in his chamber, whatever he wants. Here Mr. Spectator is also free to have his food in his room or at the dining table, whatever he prefers. Sit still and say nothing without bidding me be merry. He is also free to sit still and say nothing without any instruction to be happy. Merry means happy. Okay, so here Mr. Spectator can behave according to his own preferences without any compulsion from Sir Roger de Coverley. Okay, when the gentlemen of the country come to see him, he only shows me at a distance. As I have been walking in his fields, I have observed them stealing a sight of me over an hedge, and have heard the knight desiring them not to let me see them, for that I hated to be stared at. So he says that whenever the gentlemen of the country, gentlemen of the village, come to see Sir Roger, he only allows them to see Mr. Spectator from a distance, because Sir Roger knows Mr. Spectator very well, and he knows that Mr. Spectator is an introvert person and he does not like to talk too much. That is why he takes care of his privacy issues. Okay. And when Mr. Spectator walks in his fields, he observes that these gentlemen of the village are seeing him over a hedge. Hedge means fence. Okay, they are seeing him over a fence. And he also noticed that Sir Roger is instructing them not to let Mr. Spectator see them. Okay, because Sir Roger knew that Mr. Spectator hated to be stared at. So this way Sir Roger tries his best to make him feel comfortable at his country house. So now next he says that I am the more at ease in Sir Roger's family because it consists of sober and staid person, for as the knight is the best master in the world, he seldom changes his servants, and as he is beloved by all about him, his servants never care for leaving him. So next Mr. Spectator says that he feels really easy in Sir Roger's family because in his family there are only sober and staid. Sober means serious and staid means someone who is grave and calm. Okay, so there are only sober and staid persons in his family, and because Mr. Spectator himself is a reserved and a serious kind of person, so he likes the family members of Sir Roger who are just like him. Okay, now next he says that Sir Roger is the best master in the world because he rarely changes his servants or his staff. Okay, and everybody around him loves him so much, that is why his servants do not want to leave him. So Sir Roger is so nice a person that everybody loves him, and even his servants do not want to leave such a good master. Okay, by this means his domestics are all in years and grown old with their master. That means his servants or his domestic helps are really very old, and they have grown old with their master. Who is master? Sir Roger de Coverley. You would take his valet de chambre for his brother. He says that if you meet Sir Roger's valet de chambre means his personal attendant, okay, you would think him Sir Roger's brother. Okay, if you meet Sir Roger's personal attendant, you would think him as Sir Roger's brother. Okay, his butler is gray-headed. So Sir Roger's butler is a chief male servant who also directs the servings of the meal. Okay, so his butler is also gray-headed. That means his butler has white hairs. That means he is really very old. His groom is one of the gravest men that I have ever seen. And his groom is a person who looks after horses. Okay, who looks after horses. So his groom is one of the gravest men. That means he has a very serious disposition. Grave means serious. Okay, and his coachman has the looks of a privy counselor. And his coachman is a person who drives carriages. Okay, so his coachman looks like his private advisor. Okay, privy counselor means his private advisor. Okay, you see the goodness of the master even in the old house dog and in a gray pad that is kept in the stable with great care and tenderness out of regard to his past services, though he has been useless for several years. Now you see, you can see the goodness of the master in his pets also. There is an old dog in his house and a gray pad. Pad means a horse. Okay, so there is a gray pad in his stable. Stable means where you put your horses. Okay, although they are useless now, but Roger still takes care of them. Why? Because in regard of their past services. Okay, so we can see that Mr. Roger is a really kind-hearted person who takes care of everybody, even of his old pets. So that is all for today's lecture. We will continue our essay in our next video. Thank you so much.